Going on to the third commandment, keep holy the Lord's Day. The principle here is that God has given us 6 days on which to work, and he's reserved for himself one day for his worship. Therefore, we owe it to God to worship him in the way that he wants, on the day that he wants. Now, that's the principle. Let's see how that works out in our day-to-day life. Deliberately to miss Mass on a Sunday or a holy day of obligation is a mortal sin. Now, please note I say deliberately, because sometimes a person comes into confession and says, "Bless you, Father, Father, and Father, I missed Mass on Sunday." And the priest is thinking, "Ooh, mortal sin." And then the priest asks, so what happened? Why did you miss it? "Because I was sick." Well, obviously, that's not deliberate. Now, if you mention it in confession, you tell the priest that it was indeliberate. But if it's deliberate, it will be mortally sinful. Likewise, if you deliberately cause someone else, for example, your children, to miss Mass on a Sunday or holy day of obligation, that's another mortal sin also. What about leaving Mass early or coming to Mass late? We're talking only about Sundays and holy days of obligation here, obviously. Now, if you come in deliberately late after the beginning of the offertory, so that's after the sermon, after the creed, the priest takes off the chalice veil, that's the beginning of the offertory. If you're not there by that time, then you have not fulfilled your Sunday obligation. And if you were living in a place where there were more than just one Mass on a Sunday, let's say you were living in Wanganui, let's say, and you missed the first, you came in late for the first Mass, you'd have the obligation to go to one of the later Masses in the day to make sure that you fulfilled your Sunday obligation. Also, if you deliberately leave Mass before the priest's communion, that also means that you have not fulfilled the Sunday obligation. Now, there are times, however, where it is allowed to miss a Sunday Mass. And here it's important to understand that there's two distinct laws. There is a divine law, that means it comes from God himself. That's the third commandment. Now, what does the third commandment say? Does it say to go to Mass? It says, keep Sunday holy. It doesn't say to go to Mass, note that. Whereas there's an ecclesiastical law of the church, that's a church law that's a man-made law. And it says, go to Mass on Sundays and holy days. So now, that's important to realize the distinction between these two laws. Because there are times when you are excused from an ecclesiastical law of the church. In other words, you may be excused from attending Mass on Sunday, but you're still obliged to God's law to keep Sunday holy in whatever way you can. So you can be excused from the ecclesiastical law of the church by either physical impossibility or moral impossibility. Let's give a couple examples. Physical impossibility. Let's say that you or someone in your family, one of your kids, is sick on Sunday. Obviously, you're excused from Mass attendance. Now, you still have to keep Sunday holy, though, but you are excused from Mass attendance. Now, likewise, if you are living at a great distance, the old theologian said that if you have to drive more than 1 hour each way to Mass, the obligation of Mass attendance actually no longer exists. Obviously, we encourage and certainly commend the faithful who do make all that distance in order to get to Mass. But in fact, the obligation no longer exists. Likewise, for extreme weather conditions. Let's say that you are living up in the Southern Alps somewhere, and suddenly there's a big blizzard on Sunday morning, and you've got 8 feet of snow. Well, obviously, you're excused from going to Mass because it's of the physical impossibility because of the weather conditions. Now, besides the physical impossibility, there can also be moral impossibility, where attendance at Mass would actually be dangerous to your Catholic faith. And you know where I'm going with this, don't you? The Novus Ordo Missae. With regards to the Novus Ordo, let's give a couple examples. Let's say that I go to a Novus Ordo Mass that's totally outrageous, a clown Mass or a rock and roll Mass. Now, this is so offensive to God that, of course, I'm going to be committing a mortal sin that way. But even if I were to go to a pious, reverent Novus Ordo Mass, where the priest is doing all the right rubrics, he's saying all the right prayers, etc., still, the Novus Ordo has been so watered down and so Protestantized that I'm going to be committing some kind of venial sin against God this way by attending it. That's why Archbishop Lefebvre even used to say that because the Novus Ordo has been so watered down and Protestantized, it doesn't fulfill the Sunday obligation anyway. So that's why, if you are, let's say, in a place where you can't get to a traditional Mass, or maybe you're on a business trip or vacation somewhere where there's no traditional Mass around, you are excused from Mass attendance. Do not go to the Novus Ordo Mass, because God does not want you committing even a venial sin against Him. He would rather you say your prayers in your motel, hotel, wherever you're at, and that way you're pleasing Him by keeping Sunday holy. Now, please note that when we do speak about this, we are not judging the Novus Ordo priests or the faithful who go to the Novus Ordo. God knows that there's a big crisis in the church out there, and that many people in the Novus Ordo really are confused, and they're trying to do their best. God will be merciful to them, but to us, as traditional Catholics, God's given you and me bigger graces. We know better, and that's why God will hold us accountable. Now, when you are excused from Mass attendance because of either physical or moral impossibility, you still have to keep Sunday holy in whatever way you can. If you're able to pray your rosary, read your missal, do some spiritual reading, or make a meditation, you do that. Now, obviously, if you're running a temperature of 104 degrees Fahrenheit, sorry, I don't know the Celsius, that's be 40-something, I suppose. So if you're running a very high temperature and you're beginning to hallucinate, obviously you're not going to be able to pray your rosary. You simply offer up your sufferings, and that way you're keeping Sunday holy. Now, with regards to the Eucharistic fast, as you know, it's now officially 1 hour before receiving communion. But when Pope Pius XII brought in the three-hour fast back in 1957, he specifically stipulated that the midnight fast is still the norm. And even oftentimes we traditional Catholics tend to forget this. Now, obviously, if you are coming to like this week, evening Mass, or even let's say a late morning Mass, yeah, a 3 hour fast is obviously going to be okay. Now, if you're going to an early morning Mass though, if you can keep the midnight fast, that would obviously be the best, because we want to be giving more to God rather than less. Now, I can also understand certain cases where the 1 hour fast could be legitimate, especially in the case of someone with health issues, particularly, let's say, diabetes or hypoglycemia. They might need to make use of that 1 hour fast. I could understand that. Communion in the hand, of course, is objectively going to be wrong. However, because of the bad advice of bishops and priests now for the last 40 years, oftentimes the faithful are subjectively guiltless due to inculpable ignorance. Servile work is the work that used to be done by servants or slaves. Now, servile work is either unnecessary or necessary. Now, if it is unnecessary, it's going to be offensive to God. For example, if you mow your lawn on a Sunday when you could have done it on Saturday or some other weekday evening, you are offending God. Now, if you're spending 2.5 hours or more of a Sunday in servile work, this is going to be mortally sinful, because 2.5 hours is considered a big part of the day that we're supposed to be giving to God. Less than 2.5 hours would be a venial sin, because it's considered a small part of the day. Now, there are things that are unnecessary, even though we enjoy them. For example, even though you might experience personal fulfillment from digging ditches in your backyard, still, it's unnecessary, and that's why it will be sinful. But however, there is also necessary servile work. For example, cooking on a Sunday or doing the dishes afterwards. No problem with that. That is necessary servile work. Then there are also other occupations which may feel like hard labor, which are actually allowed on Sundays. For example, filling out your tax reports on a Sunday. Even though it feels like hard labor, it is actually allowed. What about laundry? Nowadays, it's the machine that does the laundry, not you doing it at the scrub board anymore. As a result, strictly speaking, it's not sinful to do laundry on Sundays, but we do encourage the faithful to avoid it in order to keep the spirit of the law and not just the letter. What about shopping? If it's unnecessary, it will be a venial sin. However, if it's necessary, then there won't be any sin at all. For example, let's say you get up on a Sunday morning and realize that you've run out of milk for your children. No problem with going down to the local dairy and picking up a gallon of, or liter, or whatever you call it here, of milk for the kids. That's okay, but you don't want to be doing the rest of your weekly shopping at the same time if you can possibly avoid it. Then there are times when going to work on a Sunday or holy day of obligation is simply necessary, in which case, of course, there's no sin. Then there are other cases when working on a Sunday or holy day of obligation may not be strictly necessary, but it could be very helpful for family finances. In this case, it is wise to speak to your priest for his advice.